tonight. The Western Mustangs take on the Waterloo Warriors, and it's sure to be a dandy. I'm Michael DiStefano, and I'll be your play-by-play commentator. And this is Nathan. He'll be your color commentator. How's it going today, Nathan?
It's going great. I'm really excited for this one. One of the reasons, Waterloo Western, first meeting since last playoffs. What happened last playoffs? Waterloo knocked Western out in the second round of the playoffs, and Eunice got hurt in the second game. Couldn't play in the third game. Waterloo goes all the way to the University Cup. So it's the first meeting between these two teams. It should definitely be a dandy.
Yeah, and Josh Eunice, once again, was an X factor in that one. And so it's going to, you know, Western's definitely is going to want to have to come out.
Yeah, as we take a look there at the CIS top 10, and you see Western in the sixth spot last week. They were in third, and Western did lose their last game to UFD, and Waterloo as well, also dropping from fifth to 10th. And one of the reasons, I guess, they're both dropping is they both are only 2-1. Sorry, Waterloo is actually 1-1-2. And Western is 2-1. So we'll take a look there at the standings, the updated standings. So one of the reasons why they are so low is they haven't played as many games as some of the other teams. York there out to a very quick start at 5-0. But Waterloo and Western, I don't think by the end of the year you're going to see those teams so far down the standings. That's just unusual at this point. As we take a look at the starters, we were downstairs talking. Colin McDonald, boy, is he a huge fella.
An absolute animal. He was just towering over the both of us sitting down there.
Yeah, he's scary. Don't want to mess with him. He's starting on D, a shutdown defender for the Mustangs, along with Steven Gaskin up front. Coach Karksinger going with Stojkovic. Matt Moran's getting in his first game this season, the forward for the Mustangs. We'll take a look at the Waterloo starters. There you see on defense, Ryan Hames, Jeff Einhorn, and up front, Josh Woolley, who we saw a lot of last year. He's been on this Waterloo team a few years, and Jared Perron and Greg Steffs. So those are your starters for both teams. And again, I really think Eunice is obviously starting tonight, and he's going to want to really, really play well and make up for what happened. It wasn't really his fault. He actually got a concussion last year, got knocked in the head in the second game, was not able to play in the third game. So he gets to start. And in the other goal, Jason LeClaire is starting for Waterloo. They've split the goaltending duties so far this season. Morrison, the other goaltender, has started two games for Waterloo, and LeClaire has started two. They've gone 1-1, 1-1, alternating. And so tonight, LeClaire gets the start for Waterloo. One of the things that Coach Brian Bork of the Waterloo Warriors said tonight is, for goaltending, for Eunice, is to get pucks, get traffic in front. Because that's obviously huge on such a great goaltender like Josh Eunice. And they got to not only get traffic, but create rebounds from getting low shots. We talked about this. We saw a lot in the women's game, too, last weekend, shooting high from far away. And that really doesn't make any sense when you want to create rebounds.
Yeah, and it seems like one of the only ways to beat Josh Eunice is down low and get the garbage goals. We were talking to the coach last week, and they said, you know, to score on Eunice, really, you got to just get pucks on the net and bang away and get those garbage goals. You're not going to score pretty goals going top shelf on Eunice because he's got such a great glove.
Yes, he has a great glove. We've seen many highlight reel saves from Josh Eunice. Of course, once again, this is his last year for Western. He really is out there to prove something. And as I mentioned, LeClaire, so far this season, we'll take a look at his stats. The starting goaltender for Waterloo, LeClaire, has played in two games this season. He played the first game for the Warriors and made 32 saves on 34 shots. Had a very good game in a 3-2 win over UOIT. And then against Windsor, their third game of the season, he was there in a losing cause, a 5-2 loss. But there you see the stats. Again, just two games played, not much to go on. The 350 seems not that great, but one good game and one bad game is just all he's had. So he obviously wants to have a good game and keep Waterloo. Again, Waterloo Western, low in the standings, both looking for a win. Maybe we'll see a three-point game. Maybe we'll see this one go to overtime because both teams need a point. We'll take a look at Josh Eunice's stats. He has not played 24 games. At least I don't think so. But this is last year, 24 games, 247 goals against average, three shutouts, and a .916 save percentage. He's improved upon that so far this season at a .921 so far this season is Josh Eunice. So this really, really should be a good one. And also one of the keys to the game for the Warriors, we'll take a look at the keys later in the first period. But one of the things that Brian Borg said was staying disciplined. And so Waterloo has to stay disciplined. We'll take a quick break here for the anthem.
New improved Powerade Ion 4 replenishes fuel and four of the minerals lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4 hydrates better than water. Keep sweating.
For more than 100 years, student athletes at Western have pushed their limits. They have challenged themselves with the help of skilled coaches and trainers, fellow students and loyal fans to achieve heights beyond their imagining. At Western Athletics, some things simply don't change. Even after 100 years.
And as I mentioned, one win, one loss for him so far this season. And there in the opposing goal, Josh Yunus, starting in goal for the Mustangs. Once again, you're going to see him play a lot of games for the Mustangs. A 2-1 record so far this season as we're just ready for a puck drop.
And Western's going to win the puck drop there as Julian Chimidomore wins it. Back to McDonald. McDonald has it behind his goal. Up to Chimidomore. Chimidomore to Stojkovic. Up to Marantz. Matt Marantz coming in on the against the boards, takes a shot that goes wide. Stojkovic puts it around the corner for Marantz. Stojkovic for Marantz. Marantz has it behind the goal, tries to center it in front for Julian Chimidomore. He gets a shot, and that's a good save, and goes into the corner. And Parent gets the puck out and all the way down the ice. That goes off the boards. Yunus comes out to play it, plays it to his defender, Gaskin. Gaskin with the puck behind his own goal. Waiting for everyone to change and set up. McKee picks up the puck. McKee crosses center ice with speed over the blue line. Takes a quick shot and a good save by LeClaire.
Yeah, that was a good rush by McKee coming in all on his own and gets in a good scoring position. Tries to go top corner, but a good shoulder save by LeClaire. Earlier there on that other play, it looked like Chimidomore actually took a stick to the face, but I think it was on the follow-through, and that's probably why there was no call there. He went off and was checking his mouth, but it looks like he is okay.
And Western wins the draw, and the puck goes all the way back into the Western zone. DeCoste gets it up to Harnden. Harnden takes a shot, not able to get through. Underwood blocked it. Western has it at the point. Gives the puck up to Chapel. Chapel tries to get it up, cut off at center by McKee. DeCoste tried to center it for McKee. Good defensive move by Chapel. And up comes Silas over to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg takes a shot, And a good routine save made by Josh Unis.
We'll take a look at Western's keys to this game. We spoke to assistant coach Brendan Riggin before the game to look for the keys to the game. And we're going to get a face-off here before we can get that in. But one of the things that he did say is neutral zone play, and we'll talk about that later.
Waterloo takes a shot that goes just wide. Bonner has it at the point. Shot goes wide. Pinching in is the Waterloo defender to keep it in the zone. And Gaskin comes up with it for the Mustangs. Gaskin up to Clark. Smith over to Mackey. Mackey tries to get it up for Bahima. Bonner takes a shot from the point. Blocked. Mackey has it. Down low to Sonnenberg. Good shot taken just wide. Smith back to the point. Takes a shot. Misses it. Was Ryan Mole. Bonner takes a shot. Rebound. Western finally able to get the puck out of the zone.
Yeah, scrambling in their own zone. That is something you don't want to see from the Clark and Ehrlich line.
McClurk with a long stretch pass. Icing called there.
So we now will take a look, as I mentioned, at those keys to the game. We spoke to Brendan Riggin before the game. So the turnovers. And so that can't happen, especially in the neutral zone. You don't want the team going the other way. Executing on faceoffs and tied into that first one is in that neutral zone. You really want to contain them. Don't let the other team come across with speed. If they're able to get speed in the neutral zone, it makes it a lot harder to defend, and they can attack you. So if you can contain the speed, it's a lot easier on your defense.
Schwartz worked his way up in front to a quick shot. Soltero has it. Soltero on the backhand. Loses the puck to Lines. Lines up to Alleycock. He'll dump it in, chase after it. And McDonald has it for the Mustangs. McDonald over to Paltridge. Paltridge will dump it high. And Soltero will dump it in and go after it. LeClaire comes out to play the puck. Not able to clear it. Soltero sends it back into the zone. Haynes around the boards. Alleycock has it for the Warriors. Up to Lines. Lines across center ice. He has Amadio with him. Lines tried to get around Gaskin. Couldn't do so. Loses the puck. And Unis covers that up.
We'll take a look at Waterloo's keys to the game. We did speak with Brian Bork before the game. And for Waterloo, as I mentioned before, one thing that he said is getting traffic in front of Josh Unis because he is such a tough goaltender to beat. And there you see him make a save. And right away you saw Gaskin, the defenseman, just clear the crease. They don't want anyone to touch Josh Unis.
Jimmy DeMore plays it back behind for Gaskin. Gaskin just going to slow things down as Jimmy DeMore picks the puck up and regroups. Back to Gaskin. Gaskin, long stretch pass. And I guess nobody got a piece of that puck, and we're going to have an icing. And a faceoff taken all the way back into the Western zone.
So those other keys for the Warriors, I mentioned getting traffic in front of the net. The other thing that they said is staying disciplined, because they took a lot of penalties and they want to stay out of the box, and they know Western's power play, how deadly the power play is for the Western Mustangs.
And Stojkovic tries to get up to Marantz. Marantz loses his stick, and Stojkovic not able to come up with the puck. Stojkovic up to Jimmy DeMore, takes a shot. That would deflect off a stick and wide of the net. Parent dumps it down the ice. Cut off at center ice by Paltridge. Woolley lays a hit on Jimmy DeMore right in front of the bench. And Waterloo comes up with it. Soderberg gets the puck in the zone. That's going to go up into the netting.
I do quickly want to mention, you're seeing on this line Harnden with DeCoste and McKee. And the reason this line is together, Steve Reese is not in the lineup for the Mustangs. Last year, the second leading scorer for the team had 39 points. He is the captain of your Mustangs. He's not playing tonight. So instead, McKee is centering this line with Harnden and DeCoste.
Paltridge has it behind his own goal. And McKee comes around and grabs it. McKee, cross center ice, passes it up to Beggart. Back to McKee. McKee around the Waterloo net on his backhand, and he'll leave it for DeCoste. Watterson gets it to Underwood. Underwood, not able to get it out, kept in by Harnden. McKee tries to center it for DeCoste, but hits a stick. Silas, back around the net for Underwood. Underwood gets it out of the zone, and that's going to be iced, and we're going to get a whistle.
Mustang fans, we remind you, please, to share your thoughts with us on Twitter. Follow at MustangCV and use the hashtag PurplePride when tweeting about Mustang athletes.
And Ehrlich wins the draw. McDonald has to go back for it. Tries to pass it over to Gaskin, and he has it behind his own goal. Gaskin gives the puck up to Ehrlich. Ehrlich gets his pocket picked by Mackey, who sends it back in. McDonald goes around for the puck. Long stretch pass. Icing waved off as Clark got a piece of it. Furlong loses the puck to Waterloo. Mackey, cross-ice pass to Silas. Silas, pass it back up to Smith. Tries to center it. Oh, and a good shot and a good save by Eunice, and he's going to cover that rebound up.
And there you see exactly what you were talking about before the game, how good the glove is from Josh Eunice, as that was a really good scoring opportunity right in the slot. And Eunice is able, I'm surprised he actually didn't catch that. Got a big piece of it, obviously, but nonetheless is able to hop on the rebound and makes a great save. Could have been 1-0 there.
And Western wins the draw. And DeCoste loses it. Behenna tips it into the zone. Rusk goes after it. Rusk off the boards. Over to McAuliffe. Up to Schwartz. Schwartz loses the puck to Bonner. Bonner gets it up to Mackey. Mackey not able to get it far out of the zone as Schwartz picks it off at center ice. Rusk back to McAuliffe. McAuliffe stretch pass to Karam, not able to do much of it as Alleycock comes up with it for the Warriors. Western breaking out into the Warriors zone, and they're just going to dump it in and go off for a change as Hines battles Schwartz. Good battle by Schwartz there. Amadio with it. Amadio passes it up to Lines. Lines leaves it. Shot taken by Alleycock. A rebound and a good save by Josh Eunice off that rebound shot.
But again, that was a tougher save than he should have needed to make, because the first shot, he let a huge rebound right back into the slot and then forced him to make a tougher save. If he covers that off the first, then there's not the second chance.
Paltridge tried to lay an absolute kill on Haynes there. He was able to just duck away from that one. Mario says it in front, and Eunice covers that puck up.
And that's more of what you want to see. You see there in his butterfly, he's able to absorb the puck into his chest. But earlier, he's forced to make a tougher second save because Waterloo effectively executes the shots at the pads and not high to his glove. So good so far from the Warriors, listening to their coach, Brian Bork, and shooting at the pads and creating traffic.
McKee's going to get waved out of the faceoff dot. And DeCoste comes in to take it. And now Woolley gets waved out. And Western comes up with a face-off win. And McDonald puts it off the boards and down the ice. Gets it to about the Waterloo blue line, where it was cut off by the captain, Underwood. Up to Woolley. Woolley takes a backhand shot, hits off the side of the net. Woolley tries to center it up in front. And Western gets it out of the zone. Underwood, cross-ice pass to Silas. Silas crosses across center ice and gets it into the Western zone. Tries to center it for Woolley. And DeCoste has it. Up to Harnden. Harnett, a nice nifty move to get around the defender, and a couple of saves made by LeClaire. What a good shot there. Good opportunity, but a great save by LeClaire.
Oh boy, what a dangle from Zach Harnett. I thought he was going to use his speed, one of the fastest players on the Mustangs, and just try and beat him one-on-one, but no, he pulled it through his legs, and the move worked effectively.
Chapel loses the puck to Ehrlich. Ehrlich plays it back to McAuliffe. Back up to Ehrlich. Ehrlich gives the puck up to Bonner, and Chapel has it. Chapel gets picked by Ehrlich. Up to Harnden. Harnden, a nice nifty move to get around the defender, and a couple of saves.
Mayor from McAuliffe, shot taken. That goes off a leg and wide.
Furlong with it. Furlong takes a shot. Not able to get to the center for Clark, who has it. Back to Furlong. Furlong back to Rusk. Takes a shot, and a blocker save made by LeClaire. Clark battling with Bonner in the corner. Bonner tries to flip it out, kept in by Rusk. Ehrlich over to Furlong. Furlong takes a shot. That's going to go behind the net, and Clark comes around in front. Turns, takes a shot, and a rebound, and a goal. Daniel Ehrlich off a rebound, sitting there in the slot, and just fires it home, and Western comes out to a 1-0 lead.
It's funny, because even if they hadn't have scored on that shift, I was going to talk about Daniel Ehrlich and how well he's played for this team. He's so nifty. Such a small player, but you never know which way he's
Clark,
going. He's
Clark comes around in front.
Take a look at this.
Turns,
back
takes
Clark.
A shot and a rebound in the slot. And just
turns and spins and fires, and Ehrlich just on the doorstep. But earlier, for that entire shift, controlling the play, that top line from the Mustangs, and Daniel Ehrlich was a big part of that. That's actually his team-leading 8th point of the season.
And Karam comes in and lays a hit. Baldridge up the boards. Didn't get too far as Ehrlich. Behenna has
over
it.
To Furlong.
Takes a shot and a glove save made by Eunice. You're not going to score many goals taking a shot from the top of the point if you're trying to go glove hand on Eunice.
No, and as you say, if you're trying to go glove hand, but shooting from there, not bad if it's in the pads. It could create a rebound, and that's happened a few times tonight for Waterloo.
And Smith wins the draw for the Warriors, but that puck goes all the way down the ice. Haynes picks it up and gets hit by Schwartz. Solituro has it. Solituro plays it to Schwartz. Schwartz gets bumped off the puck, and away comes Waterloo, and Behenna gets it up to Smith. Over to Mackey. Mackey back for Smith, and a centering pass, and just missed it was Behenna, as that was a beautiful play drawn up by Waterloo and a great save made by Josh Eunice.
Yeah, he stretched across going from the left to the right. That is not an easy thing to do. It looked like he did get a piece of it.
And we're going to get a whistle here as that was iced by the Mustangs.
But yeah, on that last goal, that was a lot of control from that top line for a good minute and a half. They were cycling, getting everybody involved, and it was kind of only a matter of time before they really got one in the back of the net. But it all started because Ehrlich was able to get the turnover in the neutral zone. He picked someone's pocket, and then he was nifty enough to get over the line by a fake going one way then the other way and gaining the zone.
Ali Cock takes a shot off the draw there, gobbled up by Eunice.
And last year, Ehrlich was named to the all-rookie team. He had 30 points last season. He's really a playmaker. 4 goals, 26 assists last year. This season, that was just his second goal and 6 assists for 8 points on the year.
5 of those assists coming in one game that we saw a couple weeks back.
Yeah, also do want to mention that he was the athlete of the week last week. Here on Mustangs TV, for that 5-assist performance, boy, because they were down 3-0, came back, scored 5 unanswered goals. Ehrlich was in on every single one of them. And he's kept up his strong play here tonight.
And Jimmy DeMore wins the draw for Western. Gaskin has it. Up the boards to Jimmy DeMore. Jimmy DeMore will dump it in. And glove down by Lines, who sends it up for Amadio up for a breakout. Amadio will send it down the ice. Eunice goes out to play it to Gaskin. Gaskin up to Marantz. Kept in by Silas, who takes a shot. And Eunice is going to make a save.
Yeah, Steven Silas very interesting, we were talking about this before the game, was drafted by the Colorado Avalanche in 2010 in the fourth round. So a former NHL draft pick, not the only one, of course. There's a few others in this group. One other former NHL draft pick, Kyle DeCoste, the Mustangs, but Steven Silas, former Avalanche draft pick now. There you see on the blue line, number 26 for the Waterloo Warriors.
McAuliffe plays it up to Harnden, who gets it over to McKee. McKee centers it for DeCoste. Takes a shot, and a good save made by Leclerc. Rusk sends it into the corner for Harnden. Harnden gets tripped up, no call made on the play. And Underwood gets it up, and he gets the puck back as he crosses center ice. Underwood works his way in there and takes a shot onto Eunice, but just misses wide. Sonnenberg tries to center it out in front. Nobody there to... Silas passes it over to Underwood. Silas works his way across center ice, and he passes it up to Chapel. Loses it to Rusk. Ehrlich gets it up, and Clark will tip that in. Sonnenberg to Bonner. Bonner gives it up to McAuliffe, who sends it right in. No icing made. Bonner plays it up to Steffes. Steffes, cross-ice pass, and a huge hit by Paltridge. And away comes Western. Clark racing up the side, takes a shot, and that'll go wide. Furlong gets bumped off the puck. Clark racing up the side, takes a shot, and Ehrlich has it. Ehrlich gets around his man, and he works his way in with Clark. Ehrlich just loses the puck to Steffes, and Furlong as Steffes goes back for it.
More of the moves from Ehrlich, you see, in the neutral zone even. I don't know if that's a place where you want to try that, but it worked. So whether it worked or not, though, he probably will get a talking to.
Schwartz. Over to Beggart. Over to Paltridge. Paltridge will flip that all the way down the ice. And Haynes goes back for it. He's going to slow things down here as both teams come off of a change, and Smith leaves it, passed up to Mackey. And that's gonna be offside there.
Yeah, way offside. And on that last shift earlier, we saw two step-ups from both defensemen, one from each team. First, Harnden took a hard hit at his own blue line as the pinching defenseman for the Warriors was Ryan Moll. He stepped up, delivered a hard hit, and then we saw Paltridge step up, and he delivered a hard hit. As well, so I was wondering how much physical play we would see. Early on, there hasn't been that much, and I wonder if that'll change. Yeah, a hand pass.
Yeah, a hand pass there as it was batted down.
So it will come inside the Mustang zone. And again, I do want to mention this. There are four officials. There's two refs and two linesmen. So I wonder if we're going to see that consistently, as last year we did not see that consistently. And there really should be.
Gaskin works his way in. Schwartz has it. Up to Gaskin at the point. Gaskin takes a shot, and that's going to ricochet wide of the net. Gaskin pinches, not able to keep it in as Bahina gets it out. Smith, cross-ice pass to Einhorn. And Schwartz has it for the Mustangs. Schwartz gives the puck up at center ice to Amadio, who gives it up to Saltiero. Silas gets it up to Amadio, and Waterloo breaks out. Amadio has it, and he'll get it up to the point, or to lines on the sideboards. Cross ice pass to the point to Silas. Into the slot for Amadio. Amadio takes a shot and a couple of shots there, and a good couple of saves there by Josh Unis, as Alleycock was there on the doorstep.
Yeah, right on the doorstep, but good on Eunice for sticking with it and making the save. Take a look at some of the younger fans here. As we remind you, Mustang fans, that you now have an opportunity to help Western student athletes excel in and out of the classroom. Funds raised through the Adopt a Mustang program will directly benefit student athletes. We appreciate the loyalty and support from our fans. And we do also want to mention, we just took a look at some of the younger folk watching this game, that at intermission, taken to the ice will be some little Timbits hockey players, which is always fun to watch. Faceoff will be redone. Looks like they're going to kick out the Waterloo player. No, nobody. We'll just redo it over.
And Waterloo's going to win it as Silas plays it down, cut off by Morantz. And Western able to get it out, but right into their own bench. And we're going to get a faceoff right back to where it all started.
Yeah, less than 5 minutes to go here in the opening frame, and there's been quite a bit of action at both sides. Eunice has made a number of saves. He's been scrambling a little bit, making tougher saves than he really should have to, the second and third saves. But Western has also done well at their offensive front, getting a lot of shots on goal. It's been pretty even so far here.
Yeah, we knew it was going to be. There's a lot on the line here, as both teams, obviously, with a lot of bad blood from last year's playoff elimination game, which really was kind of an upset.
Yes. I mean, the Mustangs were ranked number one, expected to go at least to the third round, if not further, you would think. And then that injury to Eunice, and then Waterloo winning the third game. Western did outshoot Waterloo in the first two games by a handy margin.
Chapel has it in the corner. And he works his way around the net on his backhand. Silas able to keep it in. He winds, takes a shot, and Beggart will block that. Beggart flips it down the ice, cut off by Silas at center ice. And Chapel loses it to Paltridge. Up to DeCost. DeCost up to Harnden. Harnden tries to get it to McKee. A good stick by Underwood. And Waterloo is able to get it out. Sonnenberg crosses center ice and chips it in and goes after it. Sonnenberg tries to center it out in front. Nobody there. Harnden puts it around his own net. Gaskin. Over to McKee. McKee has it to McDonald. McDonald back to McKee. And McKee is able to get it out. And Bonner.
Yeah, just barely. That's a place where you don't want to give up the puck. So good effort from McKee as he dives to get it out.
And a good chance there by Smith. But a good save made by Eunice. And Gaskin has it. And he'll play it up to Harnden. Cross ice pass to McKee. McDonald with the puck. And McDonald gets it over to Harnden. To Ehrlich. In comes Ehrlich. Stops up to Furlong. Furlong loses the puck. And Smith up to Mackey. Mackey works his way into the Western zone. Takes a shot. It's going to go high and wide. And Rusk not able to keep the puck in. Waterloo on a delayed offside call. Has to regroup. McAuliffe. McAuliffe's going to ice that puck. And we're going to get a faceoff all the way back into the Western zone.
Yeah, on that last shift, we saw on defense for the Mustangs, Mark Beggart making his playing in his first game for the Mustangs here, a native of West Vancouver, BC, in the BMOS program here at Western. So starting in his first game for the Mustangs on the blue line, number 23.
And Ehrlich has the puck. He's going to pass it up to Furlong. Furlong gets his pocket picked by Alleycock, who crosses center ice and dumps it in. Ehrlich not able to accept that pass in line, takes a shot, and a good blocker save made by Josh Eunice.
Yeah, Eunice continuing to battle in the net. He's making a lot more saves now than I would like him to be making, because Waterloo, these past few minutes, they've been putting up all the chances, and Western hasn't had a lot of zone time since the goal, really, which is quite long ago now, with less than 2 minutes in the first period.
Well, Western talked about how they want to play well in the neutral zone, and there's a couple of instances right there where they're just giving the puck up in the neutral zone, which is leading to Waterloo chances.
Yeah.
Chapel not able to receive that pass, and Paltridge will send it up the boards. And Chapel gets it again. And Underwood leaves it for Sonnenberg, takes a shot, goes off a couple of sticks, high and wide of the net. Underwood passes it down low for Chapel. Chapel, Julie Nemore, back over to Underwood, in the slot, takes a shot, and the puck is loose, and we're finally going to get a whistle here, as Eunice does have it covered. A little bit of rough stuff going on here, as we got Jimmy Nemore and Paltridge out there.
I'd be surprised if there was a call going one way and not the other way, or any calls at all. Yeah, it doesn't look like they're going to call anything. Just protecting your goaltender, a few hacks late, as I guess the puck was loose, and then eventually it was covered up, and Western making sure that Waterloo does not take any more liberties searching for a puck that's already been covered up. Justin Larson for the Warriors, the centerman there you see right there, was right in the crease screening Eunice when the shot came, and it was a very difficult save for him to make, and that's why he had trouble finding the rebound. But Justin Larson, leading scorer last season for the Warriors, he's definitely a player to watch, number 11 for the Warriors, 45 points last season.
Harnden takes a shot, and that's going to go up high and way over the netting. Harnden. A little more rough stuff going on.
Yeah, that's interesting, because right away, right when that whistle happened, Kyle DeCoste, number 73 for the Mustangs, he went right after Larson, and they're still talking. And they looks like they're both going to go to the box.
A little more rough stuff going on.
Yeah, that's interesting, because right away, Eunice's grill at the other end on the previous whistle. And so they're each going to go to the box. We'll have some 5-on-5 here. Justin Larson on the season, 3 goals in 4 games, but no assists so far. He's a very, very dangerous player. So it's good to have him in the box for the Mustangs.
And Haynes gets it up and over to Steffes. Steffes takes a shot and a good save made by Eunice. And he's going to glove that up.
Less than a minute left here in the first period. And I'll take as many Larson penalties as we can get here, because he is so, especially on the power play. He's a big guy, creates a lot of hectic stuff in front of the net, but also has very soft hands and an accurate shot.
Soltero pass it up to Harnden, and Harnden back to Soltero. Harnden takes a shot that goes off the post, and a goal. Soltero getting a chance to play with Harnden. Looks like got himself a nice goal there.
Stepping up when he needs to. Soltero, because DeCoste is in the box, he gets to step up on that top line. And he pots his second goal of the season in just his second game. So the new Mustang, transferring over from UNB. I remember his first goal of the season was quite a snipe. Accurate shot to the top corner, and there he just pounces on the Zach Harnden rebound. Makes it 2-0 for the Mustangs. That was great timing to get a second goal right before the break.
And Ehrlich has it. Long stretch pass for Furlong, not able to get a piece of it, and that's going to be an icing call.
I was talking about Justin Larson earlier, and I mentioned earlier in the year Zach Harnden attended Washington Capitals development camp earlier in the summer. Well, so did Justin Larson, so two of the top...